Hello everyone, it is Tuesday today, which means it's time for another video. Today we'll be making quite a special house. It's going to be a burnt one. Don't get me wrong, this settlement is safe, but that doesn't mean that accidents don't happen. As always, we start with the floor layout. I want the floors to follow along the road, so I will place them in a small angle. One of the floors will have a staircase. This building won't be enterable because of safety hazards, so I'm building it just so I can use it during the building itself. Next, we will place some walls. The windowed walls come from a mold called Woody's Wasteland. Now it's time to place the second floor. For the walls on the second floor, I use damaged barn walls. I really like the look of these, and they are probably the main reason why I wanted to build a damaged house in the first place. On the corner, I will place a small column. We will also add a third floor. This will be made out of barn floors because these are the only ones that snap to the barn walls. Now that this floor is also in place, we can start with the rooftop. For this, I use the roofs that come with Snappy House Kit. These roofs are also damaged, so it will fit in very well with what we are trying to create. Now that the roof is placed, we can start adding some decorations. We will start by placing some wall boards onto the windows. I will also add a wall board that will cover the doorway so that no one can enter. To give the building some more detail, I will also place some wall boards on the second floor. These will be put in between the barn wall and the small column that we have placed earlier. On the third floor we will also place some floorboards because now it just looks very square. As an added effect, I will also place a marker that creates smoke. This comes with the CVC mold. I really like this because now it will look like the fire happened quite recently. The front still looks a bit empty, so I've decided to put down some scaffoldings. It took a while to get it right, but I'm quite happy with the result. Now that it is all placed, we can put down some toolboxes as well. Besides the toolboxes, I will also place some lights and fire barrels. Finally, I will also add some construction barriers. These also come with the CVC mold. They don't have collision, so you can walk right through them, but there are molds out there that do create static construction barriers. And there we have it, a brand new burnt building. If you enjoyed this video, then give it a like down below and subscribe to my channel for more realistic settlement building. My name is Tuesday and I will see you next time.